Part 3 Reporter and Sub Editor. In this topic, we will discuss design and other things that are required for news gathering. Though most good newspapers have a complete design section to help editors with design, a sub editor should be familiar with basic principles of design like balance, proportion, importance of repetition, and variety. How to give emphasis and so on. Most of today's papers have clean lines, are easy to navigate, rely heavily on art and graphics, and are colorful. Elements common to most publications include headlines, text, photos, graphics, and cutline or captions. Sub-editors should understand the basics of typography, understand use of color, shape, and structure, rules and borders, and white space. Sub-editors need to know page-making software like QuickSpace and Adobe InDesign. Most newspapers have now shifted to Adobe InDesign, though some still are using QuickSpace. Sub-editors should also know the use of Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator, and Adobe Dreamweaver to work efficiently in an integrated newsroom environment where they may have to deal with online versions as well. Mario Garcia, the famous newspaper designer who redesigned Wall Street Journal and Hindustan Times, among others, given 10 tips for a newspaper useful both for both reporters and sub-editors. First, get the best stories you can get your hands on. The rest falls into place easily. Second, come to work as if you are in the storytelling news business and not in the newspaper business. Think local and pretend that the larger world out there does not exist. Think like your readers. Connect where your readers connect. Think Facebook, Twitter, etc. Design in a way that brings a sense of order, peace, and relief to readers in a chaotic world. Let your passion for the craft turn the daily miracle that is producing what we do daily very special, better, it make its magic. Be curious about what those who read you are going to be talking about today and tomorrow. Use all four of the platforms that you populate with information daily yourself. You cannot be a good storyteller on the tablet or the mobile phone if you do not use those tools. Don't let who spread gloom and doom in the newsroom influence you. Tell them you are busy chasing that good story and not to come back later. Now that you survived, pretend that your product has got a splendid second chance and it is up to you to make it better than it ever was before. Mario also talks of the media quartet: mobile, online, print, and tablet. And here are his lessons. An instrument in an orchestra, each platform has its unique characteristics, functions, and potential. Users move from one platform to the other with great ease and sometimes use two of them simultaneously. Our readers or users have become real professionals in the ways of using these platforms. They may begin to read a piece in the pretend newspaper, but realize it is time to commute to work and continue the story on their smartphone, only to finish the same piece at their desk on a computer. The process is seamless, as it should be. At the heart of it all is the storytelling. Here are 10 ways to take advantage of the media quartet. First, develop a philosophy about how your newsroom will handle the dissemination of information across the four platforms. Give this process a name and a face. There must be an editor at all times whose task is to decide how the story will travel across the media quartet. Emphasize those smartphones which are the key to the process. This is where news breaks. The first alert is usually going to be received on a phone. Expand the story via online editions with frequent updates, providing the latest headline, and information. More so often than extended videos and photo galleries, both smartphones and online are lean forward platforms. We go to them all day long to keep informed, go for the latest, emphasize short stories, but update constantly. The print and tablet editions are lean back, where users take off their shoes and get ready for more in-depth stories and analysis. Print is very much of a part of the quartet, but not the protagonist. Make sure the headlines do not sound like yesterday's news. Write the second day's headline on the first day. For the tablet, emphasize multi-sensory approaches. There must be audio, video, and longer narratives, but don't neglect breaking news here. Remember that with the tablet, you design for the brain, the eye, and the finger. Keep the finger happy. Include pop-up moments where the user engages with the story. In the era of integrated newsroom and multitasking, it is important for reporters to know photography and videography and the basics of photo and video editing. No one is going to be able to afford a separate reporter and camera person on important assignments. Reporters should also learn the use of smartphones for shooting pictures and videos in emergency and how to send them to headquarters. Such skills will help the reporters to increase their usefulness for media outlets and excel in their profession. Today's journalists have to be active on the social media. Popular platforms are a good source of news and a good way to be in touch with the readers. However, one has to be very careful while contributing to social media. Some organizations have elaborate guidelines on use of social media, but even otherwise, never cross the limits of decency and good behavior. All laws that apply to any communication apply to social media also.